This video is actually part 2 of 3, so if you're wondering why I'm sealed in an airtight greenhouse, you might want to check out the first video. Okay.
It's 12 minutes after midnight. CO2 is 677. Oxygen is 20.5%. My blood oxygen is 97%. Heart rate is 81. Guess I'm a little excited to be in here.
It's 5:30 in the morning, which means I've been in here doing this experiment for 5.5 hours now. I think I'm done sleeping because, I mean, it's not super comfy on the hammock, and also it feels kind of weird to like know that every breath you take is raising the carbon dioxide levels and is like raising the danger level. The carbon dioxide level is currently 4,200 parts per million, which is 10 times greater than it is outdoors. That's a lot. It's not uncommon for people to have that much carbon dioxide in their bedrooms. So that at least puts it into perspective. Obviously, people need to have their bedrooms better ventilated because that's not good, but it's also not totally off the charts. My blood oxygen levels are A-okay for now. Though I am looking forward to the sun coming out, because all night long the plants have not been able to photosynthesize. They need the sun.
Like us, plants have mitochondria, which means that they're respiring. I'm competing with them for oxygen, and as long as it isn't bright in here, they are putting out carbon dioxide, and it's building up.
It is the very first sliver of dawn right now, and I am so excited. Doing this project has completely changed my relationship with air and with sunlight and with plants, because I know now in here, I've spent the night in here, and CO2 levels in here have just risen constantly, and I've just been waiting for the sun to come out so that it could shine light on my plants and they could photosynthesize and soak up the carbon dioxide I'm breathing and give me fresh, wonderful oxygen. Air is this really weird thing because it is very literally our life force. It is what allows us to make energy and to live, and yet we can't see it. I've been running a dehumidifier, but the air is still humid enough that it is condensing on the ceiling and it is slowly dripping onto me. I actually had to build this whole umbrella earlier for my desk so that all of my electronics equipment wouldn't get rained on and fried. In addition to the 200 plants that I have in here, I also have about 80 liters of water. Now, I'm not going to be drinking that much water while I'm in here, but the water is very important because I'm actually bubbling air from the jar into the water. And the reason I'm doing that is because carbon dioxide dissolves in water. So I can use it to soak up, if you'll mind the pun, the carbon dioxide in the air, at least some of it. We are putting more carbon dioxide into our atmosphere on Earth, and Earth is mostly covered in water, our oceans, and that carbon dioxide is dissolving into those oceans. And when carbon dioxide dissolves, it creates carbonic acid, and that is increasing the acidity of our oceans. It's a big deal. There are millions of factors that affect the air we breathe, and they all interact with one another. It is an extremely complicated system. I don't like being all doom and gloom, so on a slightly more positive note, one of the most frequently asked questions to astronauts is, how do they poo? And apparently, that's also the question that I'm getting asked on Twitter a lot. So, if you're wondering, it's a bucket. It has sawdust in it. You know.
Right now, that thermometer outside says that it's 15 degrees Celsius. While meanwhile, in here, it's 32.7 degrees. It is way hotter in here. And the crazy thing about that is that A, the sun has only been hitting the box for about an hour and a half, and B, I haven't even sealed the box yet. The door is wide open. because the experiment's in 3 days and I haven't done that yet. Sunlight is getting into this box and it is heating up the air in this box. Though right now the air can only easily escape through here, and the rest of the heat is struggling to get its way out through the plastic.
Okay, good news, bad news. Good news is that I'm feeling okay and I haven't overheated, which was one of my concerns. This is something that could happen in here. Bad news is that I haven't overheated because there hasn't been that much sunlight. It is very overcast today, and that means that the plants aren't doing as much work as I need them to be doing. They're not soaking up the carbon dioxide at a rate that I need them to. So carbon dioxide levels are building up in here, and I'm definitely not going to make it 3 days at this rate. I'll be happy if I can make it to sundown, but we'll see what happens. The air feels thick, and I feel a tiny bit lightheaded and a tiny bit queasy. It is getting hard to focus on things, and that makes recording things extremely difficult. I've been in here now for about 11 hours, and I'm almost at my abort value for carbon dioxide. There's 8,500 parts per million of carbon dioxide. That's a lot. And I don't consider this project a failure at all, because my mission is to raise awareness, and I have been tweeting this experience as I've been going, and it has been really remarkable. I've had so many people reach out to me saying things like, I'm going to be a vegetarian 5 days a week. This is what I'm going to do for the environment. And that is why I am making these videos. I'm hoping that these videos will help people think about carbon dioxide differently, to think about it in their daily lives, to meditate on how they're breathing and the fact that even that small action impacts the environment, and we are a part of that environment just as much as any other living thing. Even with CO2 levels as high as they are right now, it's impossible for me to predict just how long I'm going to be able to stay in here, because if the sun came through those clouds right now, then everything could change directions in a moment. And it's all one big experiment, my putting CO2 from my lungs into the air and watching as that impacts the environment. It's all a big experiment, and I guess in a lot of ways you could say the same thing about the Earth. Stay tuned, I'm going to be doing an update when I'm out of the box, whenever that is.
It's over 9,000!